listened to the debate for a while now, and we called a special council to consider the EKA report. He wanted to look at the lessons we can learn from it. He wanted to discuss the action plan and decided we all agree that we should go forward, but if there were any suggestions for amendments to improve it. We wanted, bluntly, to work out how we got to this state in the first place and what we needed to do to make sure it never happened again. What I'm hearing again is a whole lot of political rhetoric aimed at the elections in May. And this is absolutely the crux of the problem which we, as councils, are spectacularly failing to address. Adult social service in this council has for a long time been treated as a political pawn. And this has got to stop. Yes, it's tempting to use emotive images and dramatic text in election leaflets. Yes, it may, if you're lucky, win a few votes, or persuade Labour voters to stay at home. We know what the American research on negative propaganda suggests, but what message is it sending out to staff in adult social services? Resonating throughout the report is the conflict staff felt between the need to make financial savings and the need to safeguard vulnerable adults. The question the report asks is why no one felt able to talk to members and place this conflict in front of them and say, we need to do this, but it will cost X. Why was it a desperate attempt to keep the lid on problems and not reveal it to members? Who created the climate in which staff were too frightened to discuss real issues with councillors? Did we all, together, create that climate? There have been more vitriolic debates and discussions over spending in social services than anywhere else. And the Liberal Democrats may be siding with the Tories now, but they were outraged, as we were, at some of the things that happened in the past on the scrutiny committee. Let's be totally honest and put our political cards on the table. Social services is not seen as a universal service. Fewer people use it, so there are fewer voting. Many of the users of social services are traditionally seen as being in the poorer labour wards. In the wealthier wards, that's how staff get too scared to speak out. That's how whistleblowers